Hello guys, how we doing? It's John from Solid Canine Training. Sorry we haven't been on Periscope for a while, been really busy. Today we got Myles. We're gonna talk a lot about how we build communication, and we're huge on building communication, especially when it comes to behavioral issues. So I don't wanna come right into our relationship, correcting him, where he has no idea what's expected, what's necessary. So our big thing is e-collars. So when we build communication on e-collar, I want the dog to understand what this pressure means. So right now we're gonna talk a lot about how we build that communication, and things for the most part is the same. If the dog's nervous, if the dog's aggressive with people, if the dog has serious bites, everything's the same. We might utilize some muzzles and stuff like that. But his obedience is great, he's been great so far, but he has bites on record. His big thing is resource guarding, so picking up socks, things out of the trash, things he's not supposed to have. When those times come, since he was 3 months old, he goes into attack mode. So before we address that, we start throwing socks all over the place. We're going to build up our communication. Once again, communication is going to come through the e-collar. Step one is going to be, Myles. Step one is going to be finding a level. So I'll see if Jess can zoom in a little bit onto this side of his neck where the unit is. And I'll talk about finding levels. So I start really low, and then I'll just keep tapping the button. And what we're going to look for is a quick little twitch. So I wait for him to stay stagnant, I tap it, might get a little bit out there, I'll get him moving again, let me reset him. But finding that good level is crucial, building this communication. Let me try to reset him again. And I'll show you what I'm looking for. So see right there, quick little twitch. That's at a 4 on the boss. So the boss goes up to 100, a 4 is super low. All I want it to be is like a tap on the head. I don't want it to be so uncomfortable that he can't listen and focus, but I want it to be enough that he knows it's there, and we gotta teach him right now how to shut it off. So his obedience is great. He's been to other trainers. They all say he rocks it at obedience, so it's not about obedience. Right now it's about understanding what the e-collar means, because pretty quickly, we'll probably do a week and a half of layering e-collar over obedience, starting to build the bond, get the trust them more, and then we're gonna set him up. And he's gonna know what this e-collar means, because we're gonna use it to do out, we're gonna use it to do step away from the items, and we're gonna use it to correct high if need be. So right now I'll show you a little drill. Break. It's just gonna be easy. He knows what place is. So pressure's on, I say place, he commits, I say yes, and I feed. Good boy. Yes is our payment, so yes is almost like our clicker. Yes means he's gonna get paid, you did the right thing, stop what you're doing, get your payment, and then we'll move on. Break. So we wanna do a lot of reps of this. So I walk him up, stim goes on, I say place, yes. Once he commits, I release, and I feed. And I'll do it now without talking too much to you guys so I can get him more in the mode. Break. Good boy, Myles. Place, yes. Good boy. And that's what I want. I want him to focus. I want him to look up. I want him to be excited. I want him to go to the middle of the mat, stay calm, put four paws on, commit, look to me when he gets the yes, and then move on. Break. Break is always our free command. So we use break for everything. Break to go to the bathroom on a walk. Break come off of the command. Break, here's your food. Break, here's the ball. Go play, whatever it may be. Place. Yes. Good boy. So nice and simple, nice and easy, lots of layering. Break. Like I said before, a lot of this is gonna be for us trainers to build more of a relationship and to get more comfortable with him, because we don't wanna be in a dangerous situation. If we get bit, we're back a couple days, especially if we get bit somewhere, place, where it's gonna impede our training, yes. It's gonna set him back because he practiced the behavior we don't want, so we always wanna be ready for this stuff. We're big fans of muzzles at first. So you trainers out there, you people who have dogs you don't necessarily trust, use muzzles, but you want to work them off quick. I think I worked them on a muzzle for about 5-10 minutes, and I could tell nothing was going to happen, especially with the circumstances we were doing. And I'm not going to push them to the circumstances I know are going to make them bite within those first couple days, so I don't think I needed a muzzle. The rest of the staff feels the same way, so we came to that conclusion. Break! Once again, a very obedient dog, but has few bites on his record. Place. Yes. So we can't trust him. We need to build his communication. And And we can't tiptoe around it. We don't do that here. If he guards socks and he attacks people on socks, after a couple weeks, there's going to be socks out here. We're going to set it up. We're going to make sure he can handle it and he can start to deal with it in a better way. Break! Good boy. So we use that continuous pressure pretty much with every command. So pressure's on, sit. Yes, pressure's off. Really simple. Break, place, pressure's on. Yes, pressure's off. Yes, break. Good boy, same with recall. Myles here. Yes, good boy. Break. Myles here. Good boy. Here. Yes. Good job. So anytime I say here, the pressure's on. Anytime I say good or yes, the pressure's off. Right when I start recall, I feed with yes just for the turn. But pretty soon we do good on the head turn. We do yes for commitment. And pretty much what I'm looking for is recall. This is the end. Yes. That gets payment. So when I call the dog, I want them to come. I want them to come to my side. And I want them to be calm. Whether maybe I need to put a leash on them. Maybe there's a crazy situation going on. Place, and I need them really in my vicinity. I don't want them just to come check in and run away. I want them to be there and be focused. Yes. Oh boy. But he's definitely a smart dog. He looks like a well-bred dog. So he knows his stuff. Break. I actually just had Jess print out a new sheet where we skipped the whole first 5 days with him. He knows sit. He knows down. He has good confidence. He knows all his stuff. So we're going right to remote stuff. Place. Yes. Good boy. He's got good confidence, good focus. He wants to work. Yes. So it's our job to work him fast and to keep up with him. And definitely we want to work with the owner where she's kind of afraid of him when it comes to him picking up something he's not supposed to have. Yes. So it's our job to set that up. Break. Good boy. Good job. Good job. So we're considered balanced trainers. Thanks. Good. Yes. But I've been doing a lot of thinking about the idea of what balanced training is. Break. My idea of balanced training is it's more of a layering. Place. Yes. So that means when I think of balanced training, it makes me think that everyone's using all these different tools the same amount, whether it be halty, harness, food, treats, all that stuff. Balance sounds like you use it all the same amount of time. We really don't. We use a lot of food, we use a lot of praise, but I consider us more of layering trainers. So we use food, we use a lot of positive training, a lot of positive stuff, a lot of easy stuff, a lot of slip leads, not much pressure, lots of food, lots of luring, but pretty quickly we layer onto tools that are gonna help owners deal with these behavioral issues in an easier way. Where everyone knows food isn't going to help a dog who's trying to bite you. You can't ignore him every time he bites you and feed him the one time he doesn't. You're going to end up with a bloody arm and truthfully a dog that likes to bite. Break. So layering is the concept you really want to think about. No matter what tool you need to use, place. Yes, layer to the point where you're phasing off the stuff. The dog just knows what's expected. The dog doesn't guard items. The dog focuses on you. The dog recalls every time. Yes. And we're known for using e-collars. And truthfully, this is the only tool I know that will give you recall close to 100%. This is the only tool I know that can give a dog a correction in the moment and stop that behavior right away. It's the e-collar. Otherwise, the dog's on a leash over there. You're running over there trying to correct him. Break. Good boy. And once again, we're firm believers in place. Correcting dogs for bad behaviors. But like I said, we always build the relationship. We build the correlation and the meaning to the tools before we correct them. Good boy. Yes. And that's definitely the crucial part. Break. So e-collars and prongs do get a bad rep because a lot of people don't understand them. Place. Yes. They just strap them on the dog and they start cranking away. That's not how we do it. That's not how anyone should do it. So I recommend anyone that gets an e-collar or a prong or any tool at that, even if you want to use a halty, learn how to use it the right way. Go to a trainer. Go to someone who knows what they're doing. Yes. Layer it. Make sure it has value. You never want to force dogs to do anything. You never want to yank and crank them. It's all about communication. It's all about focus. Yes, on the handler. Break. Go boy.
Heel. Yes. Heel. Myles, heel. Yes.
So same type situation when we do healing. So I let him lose focus a little bit. I say heel, pressure's on. I give him the mark, yes. I feed. So we're really teaching him this is the position to be in. Heel. So pressure's on, heel. Yes, good boy. So we'll do a lot of layering with food, lots of layering with e-collar. Sit. Yes, so that was him confused, feeling pressure. I'm working on a little bit of auto sit, because I think he can handle it. Heel, and I had to help him a little bit. So I'll try again, I come to a stop, stems on. Yes, there we go. You got it the second time around, so he's a smart guy. Heel. Yes, good boy. Break. And the crucial component too is if you're starting e-collar training, it's that first initial finding the level, which I showed you guys. Every dog's a little different. Don't get stuck on a number, but you have to be at a level that they feel. Otherwise, you're not layering anything. You're just using food. You're just pretty much treating them to do it. When you phase off and you start doing distraction stuff, if the dog doesn't understand remote, you're not gonna get much. You can't get them to sit for food when something, two dogs running over there, is more important to them. Food isn't gonna get it. You're gonna keep having to bump up, going to hot dogs, going to ground beef, and then eventually you're gonna have filet mignon. Heel, eventually that's gonna run out and you're gonna be screwed. So we train for the real world. Place, yes. We pretty much train for not needing tools eventually. Eventually, that's the key. I still use e-collars on my dogs. One of my dogs is 9 years old. He still has an e-collar on when lots of people come over. He still has an e-collar on when we do off-leash obedience in new places, pretty much anywhere. That way, I have 100% recall. So a horse can run by, a deer can come by, 15 people, Boy Scouts can be trekking through the woods, and I have 100% recall with my dog, and he loves it. He loves the e-collar, he loves the work. Yes. So quick little view into how we do stuff. Layering's the concept. Dealing with a dog who does have bites on his history and getting him to understand the communication that we're gonna use. So when we start to tackle these behavioral issues, he knows exactly what we want him to do and what we don't want him to do. That's it, guys. Myles, this is John from Solo Canine Training. Thank you so much. Check us out. Jeff's always doing videos. We'll try to get a bunch up. Check us out on Facebook, Periscope, Twitter. What else we got?
Instagram,
all that good stuff. All right, guys, thank you very much.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Click the hearts in the corner, in the right-hand corner, and send us lots of hearts. Also, if you have any questions about this training session or general dog training questions, you can check out Jeff's Q&A on Mondays and Wednesdays, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Also, like John said, check out our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Periscope, all our social media. You can see everything that we're doing. All right, guys, thanks for watching.
Yes.